Hey everyone, Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. If you've ever filled text with a gradient and then applied a warp to the text, you may have noticed that the gradient does not warp. No matter what shape we bend and warp the text into, the gradient inside it does not warp at all. So how can we get the gradient to match the same angles and direction as the text? Well, in this video, I show you the trick to warping text and the gradient together. I'm using Photoshop 2022, but any recent version will work. Let's get started. So I've gone ahead and added some text to my document. The text is currently filled with white, so to make it stand out from the background, I've added a couple of layer effects. There's a black stroke around the letters and a drop shadow behind them. And in the Layers panel, we see the stroke and the drop shadow listed below the type layer. To fill the text with a gradient, click the Layer Effects icon and choose Gradient Overlay. Then in the Layer Style dialog box, choose a gradient by clicking the small arrow to the right of the gradient swatch. In the most recent versions of Photoshop, gradients are divided into groups based on their color theme. I'll twirl open the Oranges group, then I'll select the orange to red gradient by double-clicking on its thumbnail. And right away, we see the gradient filling the text. I'll leave the angle of the gradient set to 90 degrees, but I'll change the style from linear to reflected. Changing the style to reflected moves the bright orange part of the gradient to the middle of the letters, so it's easier to see that the gradient is running through the text in a straight line. Then I'll click OK to close the Layer Style dialog box. Back in the Layers panel, we see the gradient overlay listed below the type layer. And notice that it appeared between the stroke and the drop shadow. And that's because Photoshop applies layer effects in a specific order. So a drop shadow is always at the bottom. Then the gradient overlay is applied on top of the drop shadow, and then the stroke is applied above the gradient. And now that we've added the gradient, let's see what happens when we warp the text. One way to do that is to go up to the Type menu in the menu bar, and choose Warp Text. Or if you have the Type tool active in the toolbar, then you can go to the Options bar and click the Warp Text icon. In the Warp Text dialog box, click on the Style option, which by default is set to None, and choose one of the preset styles from the list. I'll choose Arch. And Photoshop applies the warp to the text. I'll leave the direction of the warp set to horizontal so it's bending upward. If I choose vertical, it bends to the left, so I'll switch it back to horizontal. And I'll reduce the amount of bend from 50% down to 30%. Then I'll click OK to close the dialog box. And here we see the problem. Notice that while the text itself is bending upward, and the stroke and drop shadow are bending along with it, the gradient is not. It's still running in a straight line through the letters. To make it easier to see, I'll double-click on the gradient overlay to reopen the Layer Style dialog box, and I'll lower the scale from 100% down to 10%. And now we can really see that the gradient has no warp applied at all. I'll click the Cancel button to close the dialog box without saving my change. Then I'll undo the warp by going up to the Edit menu and choosing Undo Warp Text. So how can we make the gradient follow the same bend and warp as the text? Well, here's the trick. All we need to do is convert our type layer into a smart object. But first, make sure you've added your gradient overlay to the text. It needs to be applied directly to the type layer. Then with the type layer selected, click the Layers panel menu icon and choose Convert to Smart Object. It won't look like anything has happened to the text, but our type layer plus the gradient overlay and any other layer effects we've applied are now inside a smart object, which we can tell by the smart object icon. Now, since we're no longer working with the text directly, the warp text icon in the options bar is grayed out. And so is the warp text command under the type menu. But we can still access all of our warp options by going up to the edit menu, choosing transform, and then choosing warp. Photoshop places a warp grid around the text, and in the options bar, all of the warp styles can be accessed from the warp option, which by default is set to custom. But if you click on it, you'll find all of the same preset styles as before. I'll again choose arch. And because we converted the type layer into a smart object, the gradient is now bending with the text. You could adjust the amount of bend by entering a value directly into the bend option, but a nice feature of the warp command is that it gives us a bend handle that you can drag up and down to adjust it. And again, the gradient is bending with the text. And if I change the style from arch to something else, like flag, we see that no matter which style you choose, the text and the gradient bend together. To accept it and close the warp command, click the check mark in the options bar. And there we have it. That's how to fill text with a gradient and how to warp the text and the gradient together using a smart object in Photoshop. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel to learn more about Photoshop. You can also visit my website, PhotoshopEssentials.com, where you'll find hundreds of Photoshop tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.